Mug,
Yes.
what are you doing?
I have brought my
Bar.
pinchu. I'm sitting alone in a barn, stinking up the place, and I'm
Yeah, you, there's like a passed out cow behind you.
The people from inside the inn can just hear me playing these alluring sounds.
Can I say?
This will haunt the evening.
hell was that?
It's me playing my Quinchu. I'm not good yet. Just bought it.
Somewhere during the night, Miss Sally comes out with three mugs of beer to him, putting it down beside him, then strolling back in.
Mug, have you been playing at all with your jug?
With my jug?
All right, so we're out of initiative. You're free to head to the north to meet the boys.
Okay. Then we were out of, yeah, initiative, yes. And we just heard the yelling or the kiss me talk from.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
You round the corner, Miss Ollie, and you see. On the opposite side of this chamber, there is a large white throne. In front of it, Mug stands, like with Thok's hand on Mug's face, keeping him at a distance. While Mug's like, Mug has his pants down his feet and like trying to approach Thok.
My tongue is kind of reaching for his face.
Miss Ali just stops in her track and watches, hoping it will go further, just so she can, like, memorize it forever and use it as blackmail later.
Thok's just looking to the side and, oh, Miss Ali, have you seen a cat around here somewhere?
As Mug see that they arrive into the room, I quickly turn back and, you know, fetch my pants. Holy shit, I think that was a spell of some sort, wasn't it, Tuck?
A spell indeed. She just kinda trails closer to them. But of course, don't stop for my sake, please, come on, guys.
I'm picturing her like waggling her tail so hard it's she's walking zigzag with her hands behind her back.
And her butt swaying.
And when she stops, hands on her hip, kind of tilted slightly, and just like that small smirk.
What's going on in here?
We almost had sex because of some magic thing. So you're too late. We don't have sex anymore.
Wait, is he still having his pants around his ankles?
No, I'm probably kind of buttoning him up right now.
he's like stuffing the. Massive pile of fur back in the pants.
Yeah.
Like shoving it.
Lyra just tilts her head. There's a penis in there?
Well, it's cold in here. Do you know how far down we are?
There are fires really everywhere. Have you guys noticed that the lights are different in every single room we get to? That's been
that
normal.
Is still beyond the point. I need to know if there's a kitty cat that ran out. Where did it go?
Did you see a cat? Oh, she killed a cat. That
no, 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 not the
mighty
black.
Impressive.
It was this cat had feet and it was walking. It thought it was a big person. It was really cute.
It liked wine.
My friend Rock, I just beat the shit out of a chest. What the fuck are you talking about?
Oh, you met more angry mahogany?
Yes, angry mahogany. You could say that.
Guys, can one of you kind of go down to the other room and crush the mirror that's there? Or else we might have a lich back.
What?
Just,
did you look in it?
She just blinks, and her eye expression grows angry.
The Aurora just looks at me, like, you may burn his face if you want to.
Okay, that was a fireball at him. And a bolt, not ball. Aiming for his feet. Can I? Am I allowed?
Of course you're allowed.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Then I ready a firebolt and aim it at his feet. Like right in front of him just to scare him. If I crit fail now and hit him. Yeah, exactly. No, actually.
That's just the damage.
It's slightly off course, but like still the fire spreads like onto the feet. Or not onto the feet, but like washes over, kind of like spills.
Now take me seriously, guys. I do not want to fight another lich. So
let's
someone...
just say you should be happy you weren't in here.
And also that if you don't
want...
We've
heard some disturbing noises, though.
Yes.
Yes, there was another rug, you see, and we spanked the shit out of it. Mug was kind enough to spank it into oblivion.
Yes.
It's no more.
That did not sound like spanking a rug.
Well, this was a leather rug.
Yes.
Stop being so nosy, Leonora. Don't ask things you don't want to know, Leonora.
He says, as he sits down into the throne with...
Yes.
Thok's going to try to recover the sword.
Leonora's just standing there with her arms crossed, leaning backwards a little bit.
Is you
two cannot
sword?
Be alone at all.
Well, we are still alive, aren't we? I would say we bonded a little bit on that little...
Oh, there was bondage, at least.
Oh, yes, it was. Oh, look at you, little blank little thing.
Thok, you recover the sword. It is definitely the same sword you gave to the priests. However, it's like... The grip has been like removed very carefully, and it appears that there is an empty slot inside, past where the blade would fit. So something seems to be removed from it.
Nuclear launch codes.
Well, do you think the priest will accept if we only bring him half the sword?
No.
Wouldn't you?
Did you find the rest of it?
Yes.
I don't know. I opened the chest thingy.
Oh my god.
With my axe firmly at the ready.
Right. This chest is like glowing with slight white light.
Exactly. It's shiny.
Yeah. It's shiny. And you pop it open, and inside you see...
Well, go on.
Inside you see three bags, as well as like a linen cover underneath that seems to hold something beneath it.
I take it all and stuff it in my pants. What was the first thing you said I saw?
Three small bags. Yes.
Okay.
Small pouches.
There's three small pouches and then something wrapped in leather.
Yeah, then underneath is like something wrapped in linen.
All right, so I pocket the small pouches. Like, of course, the others don't see this, you motherfucking greedy suckers.
That's the one stuffing it in his pants.
Yes.
You do so without checking them, correct?
Of course, because I'm going to check them afterwards. And then I take up the linen and I check what's inside of them.
Burner's balls.
Well, he doesn't have that much balls anyway. There's a lot of fur. What is in the linen?
Inside the linen. Hold on. Doo-doo-doo.
Maybe I should just check everything behind the throne and just peek out and just see some
fucking box.
What's in a box?
Da-da. Let's see. Yeah, you see beneath the linen, you peek inside and you see a shiny like layered metal, basically like pieces of armor, very well laid onto the bottom of the chest. The from the breastplate, you assume it to be like dwarf sized.
Wow, this just keeps getting better, isn't it? I'm like, I have no armor. Yes, it's dwarf sized, and does it have some fucking awesome logo or something? Like a big dwarf, just super dwarf?
They say it's elven shaped.
Oh, fuck
off. It's blocky. On the front is a it's like a golden like relief of a dragon skull.
Oh snap, Misali's gonna want to get in my pants. Okay, so
and important difference, this is not a dragon head, this is a dragon skull.
Well, that is even better. Not for me.
That skull is gonna weigh a lot though.
Yes, but I look badass in it. And that is what is important.
Wait, is that a helmet?
Huh?
It's a dragon skull.
No, on the front of, like, the...
Oh, okay.
Yes, it's the insignia, though, right?
Yeah.
So I can call myself Dragonborn.
No. I mean, you might, but it might attract untoward attention.
Yeah, you might be seen as a racist.
That is also true. Okay, so I just pick up and I don the armor behind there. They probably just hear this ding, 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 ding.
You hear like this very loud clattering. Yeah. Like, oh, fuck.
Oh, this is a big doozy. Just hold on, people. I am doing something very private behind her.
As you said, the what was missing was inside the hilt, right?
Yes. So like the blade and the grip are there, but yeah. And even like the scabbard is there, just something belongs inside that's missing.
Yes.
Is there anything else in the chest?
No.
Do I wear the armor?
Yeah, you like spend some time putting it on.
How much does it weigh, by the way?
There's like it's like full body armor, so it's like essentially plate armor with like a full head helmet.
Well, this is going to be interesting. So, plate, that's mm-hmm. heavy armor.
How much does it weigh?
That's not really what I was going to get at. Do you have proficiency with it?
Yeah, that's an important question. I mean, you can wear it, but it's going to be useless if you can't actually use it in battle.
Where can I see in my proficiencies?
You are a barbarian. You do not have...
Oh, shut up.
Unless you got something from Dwarven Racial. Which dwarf are you again, sub-race?
Isn't it the Hill Dwarf? I think it's a Hill Dwarf.
Hill Dwarf does not get...
Nope.
Armor training. And neither does the mountain dwarf.
Can I get armor training?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
You can't train with it. It's going to take a while, though.
Yeah, well, it's...
You can train back in the city if you really want to.
Yeah. How much does it weigh?
Mm-hmm.
A lot. Is it
50,000? 65 pounds.
Yeah. Well, holy shit. Oh, my God. Okay, so I'm going to drop... Thok? Are you there, Thok?
Yes.
Do you need a portable ram, maybe? I have a portable ram, and I don't need it.
Is this a trick question?
No, I'm just... don't need it.
Because you know I've seen you now.
Yes. This is the weirdest fucking conversation in the... So, do you need a portable ram, maybe?
might recall seeing a portable ram strapped to the back of the good orc.
Do you need two?
What could be better than one portable ram, I wonder? Two!
Yes, that's what I thought. Hold on, there's something. This is really stuck on there, isn't it? Fuck. Okay, yes, I'm good. You want two? And I throw it just dunk, 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 over the floor. Hold on, I'm still not done shitting, by the way. Can I check the pouches just real quick? That was a very heavy portable ram, by the way.
They weigh 35.
Yes. It was very
also heavy. He looks nothing like a portable ram, but
it says so. It's a ram, a portable one.
So the three pouches.
Yes. The armor was 75.
Out of curiosity.
Armor was 65.
I just googled portable RAM. And let's just say the portable RAM I find is for portable laptop computers.
Oh shit. Okay, I'm not done yet. Fucking hell. Oh man. Do you need some giant scrotums with balls?
Nope.
Okay, I'm just gonna throw them away then. They weigh fucking 10 pounds?
Mm-hmm.
Holy shit. And I've been carrying these? Okay, there. Now I'm good. Now I can carry this motherfucker. I had to really rearrange some stuff there. Three pouches. You can see two balls rolling down in a portable ram. The cartoon is gonna be like just ooh behind, like this glimmer behind a throne, and then just things falling out.
And that would be perfect on a t-shirt.
It would.
Good on.
Oh god, he's rolling. This could go either way.
Okay. Which bag do you open first?
Can I...
Are they numbered?
Are they numbered? I would go for there number two.
There was one, two, and three in the...
Okay.
Basically, choose a number.
Let's go for number two.
Okay. You find 120 gold pieces inside.
Finally, I find gold.
Can you carry it, though? It's quite heavy.
Gold?
Yes.
How much gold did you say I found? 135?
You can just insert it into the character sheet, and it'll calculate it automatically.
Yeah. Yep. How many do you say? 100 and...
120.
120. Wow, I'm rich. I got 175 gold. Okay. And for number one... What do we have behind pouch number one?
You want number one?
Yes.
You find inside five small gemstones.
This is so Christmas. Okay. Cool,
Jesus
cool.
Christ, he's squealing like a girl.
No, that's cool. Five.
He's totally like Missali when she sees a dragon.
Well, I haven't gotten loot.
That makes me like the tiger eyes you got like earlier in the dungeon where... Yeah, there's like a black spot in the middle, but these are blue in color on the outside.
Blue tiger eyes?
Yes.
All right, and for bag number three, what is it behind there?
A portable trap that explodes in your face.
Don't.
You open the bag and find inside a jug. An empty ceramic jug.
Wow, that was anticlimactic. Is it something special about this jug?
You hear sloshing inside, even as well. You look inside and you see that it is empty, and you like turn it over, and there's like nothing inside, but you hear a definite sloshing within.
Can I try to drink from it? What would happen if I drink from it?
Is it a bottomless cup?
You can...
I think it is.
Yeah, you put it to your lips and try and take a drink, but nothing comes out.
Oh, wow, that's... Okay, so I waddle. Doc? Do you need something else?
No, I think I'm good.
I threw away some stuff, and then I come out, like, I come waddling from behind the throne, like, ooh, what is new up here? Do you want this ceramic jug for some reason or another?
Doc is going to retrieve the armor in the 10 minutes it takes. Not the weapon, I mean.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, Mug, you're going to move in front of the throne or what?
Hmm?
Move your token!
Oh, yeah. Why the fuck am I wearing a keg of absinthe? Why haven't we used a keg of absinthe before? That seems like it could have come in handy a lot of times. Hello, Stock.
Mug?
Yes, Doc.
Do you know
what the hell are you wearing?
Do I look different in any way?
Yes, you look heavier.
Do I look shiny? Don't I look shiny at all? You don't think I look shiny?
Was there a bath behind there?
There was a box of sorts, and there was this thing was lying right inside of the box.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
So, you put on the armor.
Yes, had a little shit too.
In a box.
Yes.
From a box, I mean.
Yes.
What if it was cursed?
Well, I mean, I did retrieve a sheeted dragon penis contracting some kind of... Who knows how long I have left? I need to just enjoy the live... Life's pressures, you know, I can't.
Fair point, my friend, fair point.
Yes, thank you. Thank you all.
You look smashing.
I look smashing, don't I? Let's waddle about.
Actually.
Oh. I don't know if I would have done that.
Thought's going low on the horn.
Excellent. You blow on the horn and the entire... The entire chamber, shakes violently from the sound, like it thunders, like deafening sound.
Lord of the Rings, Battle of Helm's Deep.
Basically, yeah. However, nothing happens.
He's satisfied.
Ah, there we go. The kitty cat did that just before he left. I'm sure it's a way of signaling that you're about to leave.
You're an idiot.
Yes. It's a reverse doorbell. Yes.
See? He gets it.
It signifies our departure. Let's depart.
We have the magical sword. Oh, yes. Did you guys find anything interesting in the other room besides angry mahogany?
Because this room was
another
just...
Another corridor down there.
Oh, we should probably check that out.
That's it. Just fall off.
This room sucked ass.
Yes. I hear you.
What?
I can hear you.
You can hear me. But it did suck, like there was nothing here. Other than my smashing armor, that is. I look rather smashing.
What a quaint little room.
What are you doing, Leonora? Walking in front of a man's business.
Mm-hmm. Why the hell have I got a bag icon on me?
You don't. Bag icon?
Yes.
You're holding never mind. What is he doing with that bag?
Oh, mirror. Mug,
please
you
kick
check
it.
Yourself out.
Please kick it.
Kick the mirror.
Why
do you have to be so violent, Miss Ollie?
Thok?
Just trust me on this one, please.
Do you remember when we met, Miss Ollie?
Miss Ollie walks up behind Tuck and gives him a rough push into the mirror.
Wow.
I walk over to the dead mimic and see if it has eaten anything valuable.
Okay. Talk. Are you going to resist the push? Or
I think he's.
Do you think you're going to stumble?
Weight difference won't really do much for her.
I mean, how close are you to the mirror at this point?
He's standing in front of it, just feeling, looking himself up and down.
I mean, if he doesn't realize she's coming up behind him and pushes her, pushes him, weight difference isn't going to do much.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, but he has danger sense.
Yeah.
Because she's so dangerous.
Yes. My dragon pubes are vibrating.
What?
That's just something I would picture the danger sense doing to Misali.
Oh, he's going to resist it. He doesn't want to break this lovely mirror. He wants Mug to look at himself in it.
But Mug died in that dungeon and got brought back, so he remembers that fucking mirror.
So the scene basically goes that Misali walks behind Thok, like elbow shoves him towards the mirror, and Thok like spreads his arms and tries to like support on the frame of the mirror or on the wall, whichever like comes first. So Misali make an athletics check. Thok, make a dex save.
Unskilled dex?
Save.
There.
Wow, she actually... Oh, no, he doesn't.
Mm-hmm.
He danger sense. It's against traps and spells. I'm not a trap or a spell.
Yeah.
Against
but
effects,
such as. Yeah.
Again, I'm not any effect like a trap or a spell. I am a simple push.
The effect of pushing someone.
Yeah, and that's not a trap or a spell.
So Thok basically locks his arms on the frame of the mirror and resists the push to hit the surface of the mirror itself. However, he like gets notched forwards.
Hey, what are you doing? You know I don't like hugging mirrors.
She places her foot on his butt and tries to push him further. Tries to basically force him into the mirror.
Wow.
This is gonna go so well.
Supporting herself with the tail, kind of placing it behind her so it's supported on the ground. So she can, like, kind of like, you know, kangaroos go up on their tail and kick with their legs. That kind of hurts.
She's really putting some effort into it.
Yes.
I mean, there's not much else for Thok to do than to sidestep that.
Oh my god.
Make opposed athletics checks.
Oh no.
What did you do, Miss Holly?
I killed myself. Athletics, was it?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh my god!
Oh my god!
Oh yes!
Oh my god!
Yeah. So you end up breaking the mirror instead.
There's like this moment where Misali like pushes against Thok with like her full power, and like Thok just kind of resists by like, pushing against the frame of the mirror, and then just kind of walks to the side, and Misali like lunges forwards.
Won't she then kind of push herself forward with the tail, her legs still in front of her that was previously on his butt?
That's exactly
just
what
pushing into the mirror.
Yeah. You like slam against the surface of the mirror. And Thok, you see Misali disappear.
The whole me or just my leg?
The whole you. As soon as you hit the surface of the mirror. We'll find out in a moment what happens to you.
Then you will most likely just hear a shriek as she falls forward with her leg, knowing exactly what will happen, and then she poof. Just a lingering shriek echoing through the hallways.
Huh. Would you look at that? Leora, I have some good news and some bad news.
I saw what you did. Or at least I
heard. Well, that's the bad news. The good news is this mirror is magical.
I'm not happy about that.
Leora, you haven't found anything inside the mimic. So, what do you do?
Me?
The party in general. Now that Miss Sally has disappeared into a mirror.
I'm trying to see if I can see my reflection in my new armor.
From that distance?
No, no, I'm just standing, I'm looking down at my chest, seeing if I can.
Oh. Thok's just looking at Leora, back to the mirror, and just...
We have to.
Leora walks over to the mirror, brings out her hempen rope, and throws, like, half of it through. While holding on.
You throw the hempen rope at the mirror, and the entire rope disappears into it. It, like, disappears from your hand as well.
You know, Misali is actually gone. That was the four-hour limit, or what? Oh, no, she's
on her mobile zone.
Yeah, I'm going to have to remove some cams while we wait for her to come back, because it's weird that OBS doesn't have any more, you know, plug-in or whatever for this purpose. So that you can just add cams willy-nilly.
Yeah. What are the rest of you doing now?
I'm still... Your
rope is going as well.
I'm checking my reflection. I'm like,
I walk over to Mug, grab him, and push him towards the mirror. Okay,
athletics.
Your turn.
Athletics checks.
Are you resisting, Thok?
Yes.
Mug.
Or Mug. Sorry.
I am very much resisting.
Yeah. Okay. Then athletics checks.
There are so many opposed to athletics checks. Oh, you no! Okay.
Each other, so.
Oh, that was, I thought it was me. I thought I got the six. Oh.
<Yeah. clears throat> Leora, especially with the added weight of the new armor, Mark doesn't, like, move an inch.
I weigh 300 kilos. No, actually, I weigh 260.
I just walk in and sit on the bed, just thinking... Where the hell
she can't. She can't join the call apparently now.
I'm gonna invite her.
So her cell phone died.
Restart the call. Site.
No, I'm. She's being called now. So.
Yeah, but sometimes you get the. It works for like a second and then doesn't work anymore.
Yeah, I had that issue when. I had the crappy mobile Skype.
Okay. Should we just restart it?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry about that. Absolutely everything snapped.
That's so weird. It said
stream pictures are completely fucked up now.
Ooh, lovely.
The stream pictures?
Yeah, the DM, Leora, and Thok is gone.
Yeah, I know. That was me because we lost someone.
Well, it snapped when I disappeared.
Oh, look at that. We were actually really, really, really lucky about this. Although, Tio...
What?
You're having that circle-ish thing.
Okay.
Works for me, at least.
What happened when...
Yep.
Yeah. Not now.
Should I host a call? Now I can't see him, so.
Woo!
What happened while I was gone, though?
We died. Everyone died. It seemed that Misali was the glue that held our souls together.
Yeah, I know, right? Ironically enough, because I'm a demon.
Should we try and host a call?
We have two computers.
Okay,
I think through Skype that is not going to be good quality. I'm going to try and rejoin the call.
Wait, didn't he just do that?
Nope.
No, I need to restart the entire call.
Woohoo!
Oh, there is, there is.
No, yay!
Nobody touched anything. Okay, we're good.
We're
so. Tech support, every single one of us. Okay.
Have you tried turning it on?
Yes.
Have you tried reconnecting? Okay, what are you doing?
Well, I
don't know what happened.
Oh, Leora tried to take me.
Yep.
Why am I back in the place? What happened?
I never removed you. You're just like in the mirror.
Oh, okay.
Thok's just going to look to Leora as she sits on the bed, having given up, and just...
Shits on the bed?
Sits.
That's nice, nice, yeah.
Yes,
mm-hmm. Yeah, that's
true. Fine, fine. I'll go get her. Jumps into the mirror.
Great. You disappear in the mirror as well.
Insta-death. Goodbye.
Thok, have you seen this? This looks awesome.
You have been in the, the, temple of what is shit. Now I can't remember the module's name.
Back end.
Never mind. Let's continue. Leorora and Mug.
I wanna show I wanna show Thok my awesome armor. Thok, look at this! Leorora, what did you do? Where's Thok?
Leorora doesn't answer, just walk through the mirror.
Yeah, you disappear as well.
Okay, fuck it. God dang it, okay.
This is like a remix of the Astral Plane again.
It definitely is. Okay, I'm gonna just fuck. I wanted to... I just stormed the motherfucker.
Now the funny thing would be if you shattered the mirror and just couldn't rejoin your friends, but...
Oh, yeah, that would be funny, wouldn't it?
You emerge, all of you. Like, Missali is the first to arrive, and then there's a long pause, and then Thok, and then Leorora, and finally Mug. Shoot out of a mirror... And you recognize this place from your exploration of the monastery from before. You are in the like upper floor in the like half ruined library floor of the monastery.
Am I supposed to only be able to see four squares?
Yes.
Okay.
There you go. Now you are back at the monastery.
So we basically, that was our way out.
Well, that sucked. God damn it. I was trying to do something to me, and I wanted to show Thok my fucking armor, and then that happened, and now it can't. In that particular space of time.
Yeah, but...
There was a corridor! Well,
awfully convenient and everything.
We should definitely trace back and see what was in the other corridor, shouldn't we?
Yes.
There could be a humongous treasure.
If I don't do that, it's going to gnaw at my insides the entire trip home.
Oh my god, I said this like a joke.
Okay, I'll just add some more enemies to them.
We should definitely try to get back home. I think we could probably come back here where we are all powerful and godlike. You know, we can just think about, we should find a teleporter. That would be so awesome. That would be so much simpler.
We did. It sent us back here.
No, but I mean a teleporter that you can actually tell you where you want to go. Like, I want to go back to the cave where there was a corridor I didn't check. So then he just clack his heels together and poof, we are there.
Aha. Uh-huh.
Do you like my reasoning?
Well... I mean, we have the sword.
Yes, and we do have the treasure. Speaking of armor. The sword,
give it to me, Thok.
Oh, now she wants the sword and the dancing cockatrice. Or the tips for tits. What else do you want, Leonora?
I smack him on the head with my shield.
With your shield?
Yes.
Oppose athletics? No, I'm just kidding.
That would be a dex save.
But, why do you need the sword?
Yeah, what do you need? Are you one of the imposters? Are you in cahoots with the alluring cat?
Yes, show me your priest certificate.
Show me your paws, Leonora.
I just get right up in Thok's face. You get that sword to me right now.
I lift Leonora's cape and see if there's a tail. So while she's up in his face, I'm all there.
I'm standing on my tippy toes to reach up to him.
I'm scrutinizing the back of her ass.
Looking straight into his eyes with my azure blue eyes.
Hold her, Thok. Keep her going.
Long, beautiful lashes.
Are you trying to seduce him or intimidate him?
Both.
Seductively intimidate.
Yes.
Well, I will admit my
sword
ability to hold on to weapons lately have been rather so-and-so.
Fine.
Here, take it.
Thank you.
Just don't drop it down a chasm. I'm
who do you work for?
So I'll just call it a broken sword of Palor.
No, it's not broken.
You know that it is called a Holy Avenger.
Yes. Thank you. Yes. Half the Holy Avenger.
No, it's the full thing. It's only missing.
You'll just have to like reattach the hilt.
But that is the item missing inside. Is that the magical part?
I don't know. You'll have to find out.
Okay.
How much? Nice show.
That was a very cute burp.
Hold on.
I know.
Very cute burp.
It was a long sword, so
yep.
Whatever it's
3 pounds.
Yeah.
No, that's not much.
Then I shall remove it from my inventory.
Carrying max 150.
153.1. Yes. That was mentioned. Yes. No. A dragon that was kind of nearby.
What?
No, that's a burp.
Dragon board nearby.
Like the blue dragon like passes gas for the final time.
I knew it. I was so picturing that as you said that. Oh my god. I just pictured the tail kind of do the wave.
Chat.
Pussets. Yes. Yes.
He says that when I burp too.
Now here's the thing.
So only I died? What?
Are we still waiting for the old guy to show up?
We should totally go down there and, you know, ambush him.
Let's see if we can beat him on the way back, guys.
But he was
no
walking.
Bugs.
He
come
could
on.
Be... Bugs, bud.
Think about what he could be transporting, huh?
He's not transporting anything.
Oh, but you don't know that.
I walked to the exit away from the fucking dead dragon. Around. I don't want anything to do with that stench.
Fine women these days, God.
And I wait by the stairs.
But the dead dragon kind of flew away.
If this was an orc tribe, I would have to knock her over the head with a club.
If this was a dwarf tribe, I would have to do the same.
You'd be surprised how well her hearing is. How good her hearing is. That's the right English.
Is it as good as her ability to hit stuff?
Like dwarf heads?
Do I need to come down there and fucking hit you in the face? Damn it!
Where's Missalian all of this?
Just live in the city still and I just take a bus up and just smack you and then leave.
Well, I never actually lived in the city.
No, but you know what I mean.
So, where's Miss Ollie in all of this?
Miss Ollie is currently struggling to get back internet connection so I can actually see what is happening as well as the hearing.
It's called internet mana. Yes.
Are you leaving the monastery?
I am most likely following the others.
Yeah.
Yep. There are the others. They are over here. I'm just going to... Just have me follow them quietly in the background, kind of confused about what is happening, because that's what I am.
Confused that there was no liches.
Yeah, and also that I'm still alive.
That is a good thing to be confused about.
We did mention the nearest town to the old priest, didn't we? Agree something on meeting there?
I believe so.
So he'll arrive in a month then, since he's probably walking.
Probably, yeah. The last time we zoomed in on him, he was somewhere near Balance Crossing, I think.
Yeah. Spoiler! He was the kitty cat.
Not spoiler, plot twist.
Well,
so you can head to High Baron.
Yeah.
Holy shit, that was fast over.
Okay. You start making your way down off the mountain. You're following the stream that eventually becomes a river and falls into the chasm that leads all the way to the sea. You follow it towards High Barrow. High above in the sky, you see two creatures circling where the monastery is shortly after you leave. And you notice that their silhouettes against the blue clear sky are those of now you've seen dragons, so you recognize the silhouette of a dragon.
So, Misali is still missing in action.
She's following you.
She would definitely go over.
Okay, I think I'm back now. And also, I heard something about the dragon.
Yeah,
kind of laggy. Can you please take the last part again? Sorry about this. Yeah. It's just very laggy right now.
Dead dragons. Yeah.
There are two creatures circling high in the sky above the monastery.
Yeah, where are we now?
You're probably 40 minutes down the mountain at this point.
Okay.
You've left. You see the silhouettes of these dragons circling above the monastery.
Mm-hmm. And continue.
Okay. You don't turn around or anything. You're set on heading back to High Barrow.
We just see two shadows.
Yeah, you see two silhouettes against the sky.
I nudge Hawk and tell him to check out what they are.
The Thok will turn around and squint with his mighty eagle eyes. Question is if he sees anything else of use.
You're going to hear the chink.
I will also try to make out what is in the sky, but I don't really have eagle eyes, so.
She raises her monocle.
The Thok you see in fair detail to. They do look draconic. They have leathery wings and they appear to be the right size compared to the blue dragon you met. You notice color. That they are one is blue and one is a deeper purple. Both of them have, from what you can see, just two legs.
Those
Probably dragons.
Dragons? She kind of bounces up on her feet, trying to look around and see what is happening.
Had they made it all the way into Highbarrow?
I think you're like halfway there.
Thok will just look to the Aurora, like, not sure what to do, since she's been a bit strict lately. Or a bit extra strict, I suppose.
Yeah, I wouldn't say she's more strict than usual. What are you looking at me for?
Dragons?
We need to go see them.
Miss Holly?
No, we don't.
Yes, we do.
No.
It's important.
No. I actually think we should go, because one of them is blue. But, having said that, perhaps I shouldn't be carrying around this sack of parts from their potential brother, husband, wife.
That they most likely killed.
Let's just get moving back to the city.
No, we have to find them.
Who killed what?
Those dragon might have killed my dragon.
You think another blue dragon would have slain its kin?
Yes.
You want to fight a dragon then?
Yes.
Okay, we're going to the city.
She slaps the back of his head with an open palm.
He'll take it in stride.
Of course.
Oh, they're on course.
Okay, so you keep heading down the mountain then? What is Mug doing in all of this?
Well, I'm probably trying to see if I can spot the dragons from my armor.
When he can't, he's going to try to spit shine it.
Do we know any armor shiners, armor customizables, or something in Allagan or somewhere? I kind of want some badass flames on this motherfucker.
I'm sure something can be arranged.
I could have sworn I have some spare turtle wax.
I want something like West Coast Customs armor. West Coast Customs.
Sword Coast Customs.
The Sword Coast Customs. Do we have one of those? Is there something in Seren? By the way, do we know about the stuff on the map? Like, do we know that there's a town up north? And is it Seren or Karen?
Karen?
Which one?
The one right up north, like over Scar Plain in the woods.
Oh, Karen?
Karen. Yeah.
There's an E in there.
Sorry. Is it an E?
Oh, yeah, yes.
There is an... Yeah. So,
you know, like, rough placement of cities.
We've been lived here for
long enough.
Because that was part of the discussion if we were going to stop at Harvindale or not.
Yeah.
Yeah, because that is a proper city, right? Those are kind of like capitals thingies.
Yeah, they're like large cities.
Yeah. Should we go back home or should we branch out the tips and tits for other places on the continent? Maybe
we have to wait in Highbarrow for the old man.
We could assault him on the way.
Well, that still means waiting for him.
Or are we talking about some different kind of old man?
Or you can wait, as you were the one giving away the sword, and the rest of us can go home.
But I don't have the sword.
You want to split up the Aurora, you should probably wait, yeah? And then we will go down home, and then we'll meet up in a few months.
Let's say about 9 months?
Probably something like that.
I should go to the nearest city where I can check and fix this sword.
when she comes back, you can see the big ass neon signs with tips and tits. You can see like huge lights.
Yeah, no.
You can see that these beams up over the city when you approach.
And just Smug has got some money now. He actually has enough to pay for that sign.
Yes, we should really.
I don't even think you can get neon signs in this world.
Leonora, have you ever heard about nightclubs?
Yes, and we are not turning our tavern into a nightclub.
And we have two ogres lying on this back in the tavern, like doing this. Oomph, oomph, oomph. Oh, and glass floor with dragons underneath spewing fire, so we make like this huge blinking dance floor.
Worst part is, God. You're fucking serious about this.
I think it would be awesome. A lot of thought went into this one.
Yeah, apparently.
Oh, that would be. If Leonora ever kind of walks. So if she takes a business trip or something because of, you know.
Or if she dies.
Or if she dies, I mean, that is also. But if you're a responsible business owner, you need to take the business trips.
She has her will set to someone, so yeah. It's not going to be Mug inheriting that bar.
I think Thok would be agreeing.
It's not
Thok's name is already on it.
Yeah, I thought that was going to be, yeah.
He already has half the lease.
Is it Missali or is it someone else?
No. It's Elise.
Elise.
It's Elise.
So I should find a shapeshifter.
You have never met in character.
No, yes. But it's basically Bronwyn. My tiefling.
I see. I should definitely find a shapeshifter and assume ownership.
You like bicker all the way down to High Barrow.
As we normally do.
Yeah. About the dancing cockatrice and possible renaming and rebranding opportunities. You enter the town. It's like probably pretty late in the evening when you enter. Do you? You can probably find a blacksmith, yeah. Probably best to wait until the next morning, okay, but you can definitely find one.
Order a bath.
Could I try to find someone very interested to kind of sell a keg of absinthe? It's really heavy and I didn't have the heart just to throw that out. It's like fucking 40 pounds.
Where the fuck did you find that thing?
I don't know. I think I bought it in this town, actually.
Oh, it was bought. Wasn't it bought in Harvendale before we left?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, so. Important export, woman. I'm a very responsible businessman.
I believe you actually made like a deal with the people who made that absinthe.
I don't remember what that deal was.
That must have been sometime when I was not present.
No, you were there.
You were there.
I can't remember it.
It was when we left Harvendale. Thok also bought one, and he used that to in the arm wrestle competition on the way to Pendle.
Oh, wow.
But I had no idea what it was absinthe. I mean, dude, there's so many fairies in that keg. But could I, like...
And there's one outside it holding it.
Yes.
I mean, you can, like, walk into the inn and ask him, or ask the owner if he wants to buy a keg of absinthe from you.
I'm going to wait until the opportune time. I'm going to walk into the bar, slam up the door, but I'm going to wait until the hour is upon me where the sun is situated behind me, so that you can see just this silhouette coming in, shining with a keg, just
the door
standing
faces
in
south.
There. What?
The door faces south.
So six. The door faces south. Are you trying to fuck? Is there a mountain or some shit down there?
There's also mountains to the south. Yeah.
But can I situate myself so that I can actually get...
I mean...
Oh shit, I see where you went. Yeah, now I know where you went on that one. Because there is not going to be... It goes from the west to the... Yeah. Wow, that's nice. That's nice of you. Thanks.
Took you certainly long enough, yeah.
Yeah, it did. I was actually surprised that I actually, you know, figured that out by myself. But I didn't go all dirt by that one. Yeah, okay, so that door faces south. I would just barge in and just sit through, like, present the keg.
Okay. You, like, roll the keg in front of you.
Yes, and one leg on the keg when I stop it.
With your armor still on?
Yes, of course, and I have my hands to my side.
Yeah, of course. inn owner, like, looks at you.
Now it's time for a sales pitch.
Yeah, looks at you for a while, like, and then, like, around the room, looking for any kind of, like, support as to who the fuck this is, just barging in with a keg and full armor. But then he, like, then he walks around the bar and comes to you and asks, "What? Can I help you?"
Imagine you are in a bar with no absinthe. Mug is not very salesy of it. And then a guy asks you for absinthe. What do you do?
He leans in close. What's that smell?
Absinthe. I have the answer to your dreams. I guess he's not smelling the absinthe, right? It's the fucking dragon gum. Okay, yeah. I'm just gonna go.
Then.
No, I know. I'm just gonna be. Okay.
Probably won't ever.
Absinthe will probably take that smell right out. Or you will just not care about the smell. Have you ever had fairies in your head and everywhere in front of your eyes? Well, absinthe can fix that for you.
You hear, like, this one dude in the corner go, "I have."
This man knows what I'm talking about. Was it absinthe?
Oh, Jesus Christ.
What?
I ask him if it was what? Absinthe. What? He's
what's going on, Derp?
He's having some hard...
I said it fell down my shirt and it was just my hair!
It was probably a spider too.
Yeah, you better take that shirt off and dance around to make sure it's not there. You would like that.
Well, I mean, I would have the best view.
Yes.
So I wouldn't complain. So, continue walking.
I guess that guy has some hard of hearing.
Yeah, he like looks at you like completely dumb and like keeps saying, "What?"
So I look back at the bartender and like I look him deep into his soul. What do you serve at the bar?
he like points at the wall where there's like this entire length of wall, like a list of different beers and wines.
Do you serve absinthe? Let's not go through the entire inventory.
I don't think we have absinthe, no.
Do you want to buy absinthe, maybe? Perhaps?
Doesn't that stuff make you blind?
No. That is watered-out beer that makes you blind. This stuff makes you look like a god. Everyone would admire you with this.
Well... We don't take kindly to blasphemy around here.
It's not blasphemy, I swear. This would put this town on the map. You would be the only town within 200 meters.
I can show you that we have a map in the back.
There's not a lot of salesmen coming through here, is there? Or is it just kind of a simplified transaction you're looking for? What if I told you I was a very, 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 very famous adventurer and I could sign that keg for you? Look at my armor. Look at my armor. Have you ever seen anyone just walk in here with this kind of an armor?
trying to sell you absinthe?
No. Can't say I have, no.
Don't you feel like you should take part of this opportunity? I'm trying to seduce him with my eyes.
Are you leaning close?
I lean in as close as I can go, without falling off the keg.
He like takes a step back, like wafts there in front of me.
I'll leave if we do this transaction.
It just gets worse.
Yes. I can promise you it can get even worse.
Oh, I'll give you 20 gold for that. And for you to never come inside my establishment again.
I would have to go for 45 if you want me to never come into this establishment again. 35? 32? 34! I will not go any penny more, less. I keep 28.
20.
You drive a hard bargain. I will, I kind of unlatch one of the sides of my armor and I go like this towards him.
No. 22.
You have yourself a deal. Let's have a little hug about it, shall we?
You like go and give him a hug and you feel like this warm liquid just kind of start pouring down your...
Well, it's gotta be better than the dragon remnants. Could I have a beer for the road for the compliments of this? And I shall leave momentarily. I shall leave right away.
Yeah, you like release him from the hug and he like runs to behind the bar to fetch like a bag of gold. And he like shoves the gold in. He doesn't even make sure that it's the right amount. Like shoves it at you and then like follows it with a beer.
I lean up towards the bar and just, this man knows service. Stop drinking the beer.
By now, Thok's gonna pop his head in the door. Just, oh, and you found an inn. Excellent. We're staying, right?
This is the best place ever, Thok.
Excellent. Walks in and
sees that mug is not covered in vomit.
Yes, I do think and per
just
our.
Turns and walks right out again.
Per our arrangement, I think I have to sleep in the barn tonight.
She just turns on her heels in the door and just goes out.
I have that effect on women.
Now, please leave the establishment.
Yes, Thok, we will see each other tomorrow. I made a very lucrative transaction, but there was a clause, and I have to sleep in the barn tonight. We'll see you tomorrow.
Uh-huh.
Yes. Could you, by the way, pack some beers when you go?
Sure. Yeah.
Thank you.
I return inside as I see Mug leave.
Wow.
Mug, like, waddles towards the bar. Clang, 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 clang.
Oh, God.
He's clearly not used to wearing armor.
No, not at all. How tall is this building, by the way, and where would they be sleeping?
The building is...
not that I have any plans.
What, you got a parkour up the walls?
The building is a two-story building.
Two-story. And the barn, how is that situated?
There's like a courtyard between the inn and the barn.
Oh, damn it.
There's like a stable attached to the side of the barn.
I'll just, for now, I'll just finish my beer in a little pile of hay in the barn. very content with myself.
Sure.
Leonora just helps herself to the back room of the tavern and finds a bucket and some cleaning water and cleans up whatever puke there was on the floor. Because.
Oh, so helpful.
The owner of the place just like raises an eyebrow as you like walk straight into the back room and then walk back with cleaning gear. He just like shrugs and says to like one of the regulars at the bar that, huh, haven't seen a helpful elf in a while.
Well,
meanwhile,
when the asshole of my crew makes you puke, I feel this is my way of apologizing for his assholishness.
Huh. Sharp ears, too.
Yes, I have. There's a reason they call us knife ears, and it's not because of our damn pointy ears. We have sharp ears.
We're a crew.
When Miss Sally
comes...
Yeah, Miss Sally.
When Miss Sally comes inside, she quickly scans the room to see how many people are there.
It's like a dozen people.
You can't, sadly.
Like
yeah?
13, 14.
Is that a lot of people for that bar, or...?
It's not, like, packed, but it's pretty full.
Miss Sally then skips over to the bar, looks at the one behind him, and asks... if he needs a barmaid for the night, telling him that she would gladly dress up in whatever maid outfit she would have as long as she gets paid for the night. Most likely with a room, a meal, and maybe some gold, whatever tips she could get.
Talks about to cut in just,
she does very good maiding.
And of course, leaning forward on the desk, yeah. Like... blinking innocently, and yeah,
of
you know.
Of course, cold. Yeah. The
her
the owner like
peeping behind her.
Yeah, the owner's eyes are clearly locked on your boobs as you like lean forwards. He says, "Oh, we don't have any special clothing."
No, that's fine. I have my own.
I have. Yeah, sure. Sure, I'll hire you for the night. Sure, of course. Cover the room and you can keep the tips.
Will I get a meal for the night too? I've been traveling very far, she says to bats her eyelashes.
Oh, of course.
Thank you kindly then. Is there anywhere I can change? She smiles and kind of straightens up and
yeah.
Looks all innocent and adorable.
Yeah, he like
the Aurora just lifts up the bucket. If you're gonna work there, take this out.
The owner points to like the back room where the Aurora got the bucket from in the first place.
Yeah, Miss Sally just waves her hand at the Aurora and just like, nah, that's not the barmaid's job. That's like, you know, other people. Go now, sweetheart. And then she strolls off to the back room and
fill water over your head, girl.
She has already long disappeared and locked herself in the other room to change over to a maid outfit.
Leorora just puts the bucket away and orders a room with a bath.
Thox saunters over to the bar desk and just leans over and just...
I will tell you if she is single or not for a single mug of beer.
The owner like looks towards the back room and then to you, like hurriedly pours you a beer, like shoves it to you.
He takes his first sip and just,
yeah, she's single, but you're no dragon.
And just as he says that, Miss Sally comes out again in her skimpy maid outfit with her tail sweeping behind her, swaying her hips as she walks.
Yeah. Talk, you see like the owner stand in front of you and like turn to see Miss Sally and then just bang straight on the floor. You like peer over and you see like this stupid smile on his face.
He'll turn towards the rest of the establishment and just, well, looks like the next round is on the barkeep.
And I will bring them to you all, she, Miss Ollie says, and waves her hand, kind of courtesying in front of everybody, lifting her skirt just a little, tease everybody, and then walks over to take whatever order people want.
Okay, so the night is especially interesting in the tavern. I'm assuming that Leorora is the first to turn in.
Yeah, she's probably cleaning and polishing her armor and having a nice hot bath and finding a soft bed to sleep in.
Will more people arrive during the night, though? Or will it be...
definitely.
We'll see about that.
Especially as the first, like, walk out and, like, start spreading news of a one-time barmaid. In the establishment. Mug.
Yes?
What are you doing?
I have brought my pinchu. I'm sitting alone in the barn, stinking up the place, and I'm...
There's like a passed out cow behind you.
The people from inside the inn can just hear me playing these alluring sounds.
Can I...
This will haunt the evening.
What the hell was that?
It's me playing my quinchu. I'm not good yet. Just bought it.
Somewhere during the night, Miss Ali comes out with 3 mugs of beer to him, putting it down beside him, then strolling back in.
Mug, have you been playing at all with your... jug?
With my jug?
Yes. The jug you got. Or found.
Jug, yeah. Done in
that. I should probably try to figure out how that works. Yeah, I will do that.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, there's like a few hours in between the tavern being taken over and Miss Sally coming out with beers. And I'll show you what you can do with that jug.
He looks so skeptical.
I have learned not to have expectations.
You have learned not to trust him, I think.
Yes.
Right one.
Look at his smile.
You should have a handout.
Probably if I just bring up my actual... no?
Then I would know.
There we go. Oh, holy shit.
While he's reading that, Mr. Thok's actually just going to discard one of the portable ramps in the rooms. Just leave it there.
Sure.
Finders, keepers, I suppose.
Yeah, you like lean this massive tree trunk against a wall somewhere. Just whistle as you walk away.
Nobody will ever know.
Meanwhile, Miss Sally is flirting her best with the customers, her usual routine, brushing her hands over people's shoulders, letting her tail sweep across their feet. The whole... you know,
the whole shebang.
Attention,
yeah.
Kinda.
As his drinking buddy is left out, Thok instead decides to retreat up and have a chat with Leorora for the rest of the evening before he also turns in. Still not done reading? Jesus. Did you give him a book?
Can I, like, just... I just have to say the word and then boop.
Yeah.
Okay. This is going to be interesting. So I'm sitting there alone, all by my lonesome.
Yeah.
Out in the barn and practicing. Beer. and then kind of just hear this. Right? Wouldn't that be beer? That would be awesome right now. What would, do I hear something from the jug as I say the word beer?
Yeah, you you hear like this sloshing inside, although you're pretty sure that it's still right now.
So I turn my gaze to the jug, and now I can see the actual beer inside.
Yeah, like see it completely topped off with a friendly layer of foam.
Okay, so I'm not going to tell any, I'm just going to sit here and just, oh my lord, what just happened? And I'm going to start drinking from this jug.
Of course.
Of course, and I guess it will take me like...
like a couple of hours later, Misali comes out and you're like completely shit-faced.
Yes, I would say both beer and I would say mayonnaise, wine.
Jug in hand, just, oh bad.
Wow, okay, I can see some, definitely some horrible things can be happening to this.
No, Mug's probably going to be effectively useless the rest of the adventures now. We have to drag him around, literally.
That's my cunning plan. Just feed Mug all the alcohol in the entire, like, world.
That is, yeah, it couldn't have...
And then give him, like, shiny armor until he can't walk. Just completely useless.
This DM is brilliant.
It seems like there was some thought behind this one.
Thok, did you want to go see the Aurora?
Yeah, just idle chatter before he heads off to bed.
Okay.
Yeah, and she will ask him what the hell he meant about her being his conquest.
I'm very sleepy right now. Good night.
Not good enough. Answer me.
I really need to sleep. Alright, I'll sleep
on this. Grab his arm and say, answer me.
Well, I didn't actually mean conquest as in conquered, but I would like to become a conqueror.
I give up. If you can't talk to me, this is gonna get hard.
Well, things are already hard.
I'm gonna play this all night.
Is my window facing out towards the barn? Can it please be facing out towards the barn?
That would be awesome if it did. Please let it be facing out to the barn.
Sure.
I go down.
You go down?
Bucket with the puke-stained water.
There's like a quite a long distance between the barn and the window if you're trying to
throw. No, okay.
Yes.
Never mind then. I don't want my window to be turned out that way. Oh, stop!
Yes.
Wanna make loud noises on that? I'm just
kidding. What did she say?
I'll be in my room.
Good night.
I'll be in my bunk.
I will start collecting stuff. Before I leave tomorrow, I'm going to have another proposal to the barkeep. I'm going to just start filling. Do I have anything in the barn? Like kegs, whatever?
Whatever you bought with him. So
I don't have any empty kegs that are just standing in the barn?
No.
Making it hard on me, DM. But there was a pig that kind of
and remember expired. That there is a maximum amount. It refreshes at dawn.
I refresh the dawn.
So you can produce 4 gallons of beer from it per day.
So he's not going to die of alcohol poisoning, at least.
I'm not going to die of alcohol poisoning. Fuck. Okay, so I get like 4 gallons and that's it. I'm done in 4 minutes.
That's just a mouthful.
Yes. Oh my god. I need to find an enchanter and just kind of, you know, spruce this thing up.
Turn it up to 11.
Yes, I want a turbo on this motherfucker. Yeah, okay. I'm going to just practice my quinshu until dawn and then...
Correct.
No sleep.
I mean, it's hay. I'm used to lay on the rock and stuff.
Okay. Yeah.
It's way too comfy.
So eventually morning arrives. Misali, roll a 5d100.
Oh damn! Now what is he thinking?
Rolling repairman.
How was it? I typed this again.
You can /roll. Yeah, you can either slash roll or put it in double brackets.
Roll 5d100.
Yeah,
oh, wait, I almost typed
if
it
you're
in.
You're using brackets, just type the 5d100.
Double brackets?
Mm-hmm. There you go. You have gained 328 gold.
Nice.
Everyone? Me too. Did I gain 328 gold?
And that was
three.
The tips.
Oh my god, Miss Holly. I slept in the barn.
But you got 22 gold for it.
You're not completely broke anymore, Mug.
I know. This has been quite a successful looting for me, but I had to sleep in the barn.
And you got 4 gallons of beer per day out of it too, so.
Yes.
4 gallons is a lot.
And acid and basic poison, beer and honey and mayonnaise and all
that.
Yeah,
if you want to make those.
You know, 40 gallons is 151 liters, right?
It's 4 gallons.
Yeah, so it's not that much, Liarora. Stop.
Okay, it's still 15 liters.
You're still giving me false hope.
15 liters of beer is kind of a lot.
Yeah, it's like a 6-pack of... It's not that much. That's like a 6-pack of big beers. Huge-ish, actually.
So, morning comes. All of you start getting up. We get this, like, flash to somewhere in the mountainside with this, like, old man walking with a cane. We see the light shining just over the mountain tops.
Does it hit my armor?
No.
You're not there. Then the camera like pans across the mountain tops, and then we pan down to see High Barrow. Then we see Mug like waking up in the barn, still in his armor.
And you can hear that.
I used to be able to play that on a recorder.
I picture that is quite the. But I still reek though, so every goddamn live animal is dead.
Yeah, there's still the passed out cow behind you, definitely. Yeah. It probably like stood up at some point during the night and woke up, and then just like collapsed again. So what is everyone doing with their day?
I'm going to a blacksmith as soon as I get up.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
But we've had a long rest now, right?
Yes.
Oh yeah. Well, experience.
So I can put my like health point back on and stuff.
Yes, you took a long rest, so you can reset everything, basically.
Oh, yes. I spelled it. Zero.
All of you have gained 2837 XP.
What? Holy shit.
Plus?
That was more than I thought I was gonna get. Blackets.
First, I gotta kind of figure out what the fuck I have. Maybe I level? Who knows?
Doubtfully. Who knows?
31225.
Closing up on the end. No, don't worry.
Thok's, of course, going to have himself a hearty meal.
Yes! I am of course. Leveled.
I leveled up!
Me too.
I am the only one not leveling up. That is so unfair.
Oh, I need 8k more to level up.
Yeah, but you are already a level ahead of me.
Of course. Let's see. I have a d8. What was it again? A plus level? For health?
For health? No, you roll die plus your constitution modifier.
Con mod. So that's 1d6 plus.
You can just press the hit dice button.
That works too, but that always sucks for me.
He says, and then look at what she did.
Or you can just press the hit die button.
7.
2 health.
Yeah, well, I got 2 more, so now I have 45 health.
Holy shit, I got 94. That is, now I feel OP. Oh, well, what is the armor class of the armor I got, by the way?
Plate armor?
Yeah. I mean,
technically, you can use it in battle.
Oh, yeah, technically I can't.
I'll need to see what, see.
Plate armor base armor class is 18. Also, there is a strength requirement, just so you know.
I'm quite strong. What is the strength requirement?
You'll probably breeze a bit. 15.
No, I got 20.
Yeah.
I'm strong. Me big elf. Dwarf. Let's not talk about what just happened. Where the fuck is the your player's handbook, Chris?
I don't know. Should I relink it?
I have my laptop in the Dropbox.
I think I have it in the...
Yeah, so, Zeph, if you continue wearing that armor, you will have disadvantage on all rolls involving strength and dexterity.
Aren't you a motherfucker? So I shouldn't wear it until I actually have proficiency.
Nope. You should probably find out what it actually does as well.
What it does?
I wonder if you're able to remove it. Is it cursed?
Should you kind of shut your pie hole?
Is it magical at all?
Do you want it to be cursed?
Are you asking me or him?
I would love it to be cursed.
Also, Seb, roll a constitution save.
Why? You must have.
I think he's struggling enough with the curse between his legs.
Why am I going for... Oh no, what is the disease? Fuck, we need to find a healer for people.
Oh, please tell me you made like 20 different options and you just rolled for the disease he's getting.
I don't hope you... Because that is a... Since that is... A fucking possibility, or I hope he doesn't do that. Reasoned.
He is making his note upon his grand wall of.
Yes, a note has been made.
I don't like that. I actually hate that.
How unfortunate.
Of course.
There it is. Well, I actually forget what the DC is.
So he just made one up. What is the level? Where the fuck is the level table?
Should be at the start of the player's handbook.
Thok has made quite the.
Chapter 3 classes.
Ability score improvement. It's ability score improvement or a feat.
But is
depends on the class.
What level are you hitting?
Exactly. What level am I hitting? I think I'm hitting
eight.
Eight. Yeah.
Yes. Ability score improvement or a feat.
What is the next level? Like the points of the next level, so I can add that for to the.
The story on the PR one.
Level 9 is 48,000.
48,000?
Yes.
Holy shit, that's gonna take a while. Do I gain anything on level 8?
I just told you. You either get.
I see here now.
Yes. You either get an ability score improvement, or you can sacrifice that for a feat.
Would that feat be
heavy armor master?
Yeah,
heavy armor mastery.
I can't do that, can I?
That is the feat. Is it heavy armor mastery, or is it? It's called as much as.
Behold, Twitch chat. This is what happens when you really want something.
It's actually called heavily armored. Heavy armor master is a tanking. A thing that you can take afterwards. Yes,
that's true.
Where the fuck are you seeing this? Where the fuck? Where did you?
I have
feat list.
Feat list is in chapter 6, underscore, page 156 is the feat in question. Heavily armored. Prerequisite is just to wield medium armor, so you increase your strength by 1 up to a maximum of 20, so you can't get that, but you gain proficiency with heavy armor.
I'm gonna go for heavily armored. Now I can use my armor. The DM can't fuck me. Well, he can, but... That's not... Could everyone just pretend they didn't hear it?
Nope.
Okay,
so I'm going to add that into my background or my spell book.
I think you could have taken Lucky or Mage Slayer.
Lucky, isn't that what you got?
Or yeah, I've got Lucky.
Yes, I forgot to give myself the Death Ward and Guardian of Faith last level. Holy fuck.
Where the fuck do I add the feats? Is that in background?
You just make a note of it in background.
So, any other notes then? No, weapon armor proficiencies. Da 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 da. Heavily. That is such a loud keyboard.
Tuckety tuck tuck tuck.
Okay. So, at 7th level, I didn't get anything. But on 8th, that's when I get these two. Okay.
Didn't get anything cool at the level 8?
No, I'm not.
Let's see, the cleric. You sure?
I got them now.
Anything on level... No, yeah, I mean for level
just
7.
Just spell slots on level 7.
Wow, that's the boring level.
Yeah, there are a few. But I mean, it's spell slots, so...
And
well, now I can infuse my weapon strikes with divine energy.
Now she has destroy undead, a divine domain feature.
Yeah,
the ability destroy undead improved. I've always had. It's just that I'm not putting.
You've had turn undead.
Turn undead.
No, I had destroy undead too. That came at level 6.
No.
Level divine six domain is, feature. Maybe.
Unless you have the your life domain.
Yes.
Oh yeah, it was because you now have a it now affects creatures up to challenge rating 1. That's the improvement there.
Yes.
So now you can maybe do something about the skeleton.
What would happen if I was to sell this plate armor?
It's
fucking pricey as fuck.
Yes, it is.
Infuse your weapon strikes with divine energy. You can cost the attack to deal an extra d8.
You'll only get half of it though, since it's used armor. But
I hate
still,
you a little bit,
750
I mean,
gold.
It's not worth
you
it for me.
You could try and sell it if you want to, or you can take the feat and wear it.
I will wear it. I have the feat. I will wear it.
But when it doesn't say anything for recharge and stuff, I'm guessing I can use it as many times as I want, but it doesn't say anything about it.
What's the...
Destroy undead, it doesn't have anything.
I think those are once per rest. I think they're channel divinity... Yeah, it's under General Divinity. When you use your General Divinity, you choose which effect to create. You must then finish a short or a long rest to use your General Divinity again.
General Divinity. Beginning at 6th level, you can use your Channel Divinity twice between rests.
Yeah, that's probably an improvement.
So that's max two.
That's under Channel Divinity.
Not yes, the last line of Channel Divinity main area.
Wait, Channel Divinity preserve life. I need to use that twice. That's the only thing. Turn undead.
This is why I have a notepad ready with all this stuff. Which I have actually gone through and scrapped the idea of going down the rogue route. So, instead.
Leorora.
Mm.
you reach the village blacksmith, and he agrees to fix the hilt of the sword for you.
Also my bag of holding.
Magical items can't be repaired.
What can I do with dust of disappearance, though?
Use it.
What does
it disappear? You just puff it over you and you're invisible.
You can either make a very fancy cloud during which you can run in the other direction, or you can actually put it on you and become invisible.
Like a magic. Like a magician.
Yeah. It acts just like the invisibility spell, doesn't it?
I think so.
Well, that works then.
I think you should have a handout for that as well.
Yep.
Yes. With the details.
It lasts quite a long time, actually. Concentration up to 1 hour, unless you do anything hostile.
Okay, we lost Missali again.
continue.
Yeah, Leorora, the blacksmith, agrees to, repair the sword for a measly 5 gold. Since it's just basically reattaching the hilt to it.
Yeah, I just removed 5 gold.
Yep. Nothing more exciting than that. Are you going to spend the time waiting around in town for the old man?
Is there a target practice anywhere?
I mean, there's...
like a place where I can test out the sword if... actually has any powers left?
Yeah. I mean, you can absolutely try it out. You don't need, a training area for that.
No, okay. I just want to know if it still works.
Yeah, you can, swing it around and, I mean, once it's repaired and you're holding it, you can sense that it still has
power. It's still powerful as it was before it was broken.
Yeah.
Can you... No, I can find it myself. It's a handout. I'm gonna equip that. Where is it?
The sword. Is Misali coming back in, or...?
Let's hope so.
Hope so, yeah.
Does it do with base damage of a longsword?
Yes.
Okay. Just tell you
can add the magical two-hit bonus.
It's a +3.
Yes.
So, +3 to damage and +3 to hit.
Yeah, she should start... hitting more stuff now. Hopefully.
Yes, eventually. But wasn't there something else with it too?
Did you put it in the stuff here?
I can't find the handout, so.
No.
No, not you can't there anymore. It is. It's in the handout, item handouts. It's under lore.
You gain a 3+ bonus to attack, damage roll with his major weapon. With it, the creature takes an extra 2d10.
Where did we put the goggles of the night? Didn't we leave those back?
I think you left those with someone.
I'm gonna save all of this.
Yeah, we left them in the tavern.
No,
we didn't really have anyone to.
It is a handout.
Yeah, I'm just gonna save all of this in my thing so I can actually remember that it gives bonuses to people.
As if you're gonna remember that either way.
That was instant. Thok's gonna start asking around if they know of anyone good at enchanting or imbuing armor.
Imbuing meaning?
Or working with dragon scales to enhance armor.
Oh yeah, because you actually have some of those left.
Yes.
You ask around in like the inns and like shopkeepers in town. All of them like point you to either the Elven realm to the west, or probably more likely to find one at Cairn.
Made a note of that.
You're fairly sure that you haven't heard of anyone who would do that in the south.
Well, he is content with that for now. Shall we just say that time passes then until the old man shows up?
Sure.
That's where we agree to wait for him, isn't it?
Yeah, if you want to wait for him, then sure.
Yeah, because he did specify he was taking the mountain route, wasn't he?
I believe so, yeah.
Too many passages, we might miss him. Let's just wait.
He's like going through here.
What's the crit on a longsword or? The
crit is the same as everything.
Yeah, the same damage.
It's 20. Okay. Oh, well, crit is
no, crit damage.
The damage is the same as the base damage.
Oh, yeah.
You just enter it a second time.
D8. I don't know why it's 2. There you go. And I put magic bonus on this one, right?
Yeah. +3.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Have you seen the Winter is Coming versions of...
That's it.
Oh, that is?
Yep.
I just see the first pictures of...
It's a GIF, so if you click on it, it'll send you to the page.
So, versatile goes under finesse?
Nope, versatile is versatile. It means you can use one hand or two hand. Finesse means you can use either strength or dex.
Say which one
finesse. It's not a finesse weapon.
Okay.
Versatile
means that you can wield it with two hands and get...
But it's still a strength weapon. Then.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Spellbook.
And for a long sword, it's a 1d8 in one hand and 1d10 in two hands. So you probably want to set up two different versions if you ever plan to strike with. So you don't have to do that then.
Oh, I will always be using my shield. So.
Sip, are you looking at the alchemy jug again? I saw that.
No reason whatsoever.
Are you going to poison someone?
No reason whatsoever.
You can't poison the DM, you know.
Well, that we know of.
Any word from our dearest tiefling?
She's not back to Skype yet, is she?
Shay! SMS her.
Yeah, Shay, you got the direct link. Jesus, why have you done it yet? Jesus. Because I am the master blacksmith that I am. That I haven't done anything about. How long would it take me to do basic stuff? Because I'm tool proficiency, brewer supplies.
I mean, what kind of?
I didn't... What was it that I had? Smithing proficiency and brewing proficiency. And I had this letter of introduction from the Black and Smith.
Yeah.
Didn't you like that, Sirkesh? Black and Smith. It. Yes.
I loved it.
Smith and Metal Forges.
So, I mean, you have essentially like at least a week of downtime if you want to try doing something. Do you want to just like practice your profession as a blacksmith, or do you want to try and craft something specific? That's kind of two different things mechanically.
I don't know. What do I need? I will try to brew the most insanely strong alcoholic beverage there is.
That needs time, though. A lot more than a week.
About more. What if I use acid? Because I got acid.
It's not going to help you.
Well, it would speed
you're
going
to turn blind.
Fermenting.
or worse.
You roll your craft check, and whatever the check is determines the progress. What is a craft check, guys?
It's basically a check using your tool proficiency.
Ooh, so I should actually do that with the custom one and stuff.
If you... if you want to do something with your tools, it's going to be a d20 roll with your proficiency added if you have proficiency in those tools. You may get a dexterity or strength or something like that in there.
Yeah, I see. Like, if I was to make a custom skill, I have to go for a stat, and then if I'm proficient or not, and then a bonus. Yeah.
But so it does depend on like what you're trying to do in the first place.
Yeah.
Because if you're just trying to do something in like general for profit, then that's gonna be like the business rules apply to that.
Oh my
god. Not
God.
So much crafting.
You're gonna love the spell I just got.
What's that then?
Death ward. It protects people for 8 hours from death.
Oh. That's nice. That's unfortunate.
That is unfortunate.
So can I like make something now that I could be able to sell before we leave?
I mean, kind of. You're gonna spend like week, maybe week and a half in the town.
We are going to do that now while we wait.
If you want to wait around for the old dude to arrive,
yeah.
Then
then I'm going to use that time to kind of make something very awesome to sell to someone. Do we have? Is there a blacksmith or something in town?
Yeah.
Is he very proficient in what he does? Is he very awesome at what he does?
he's like shaped a few swords in his time, but he's definitely like a mainly farmer's tools kind of guy.
Awesome, because I am, of course, one of the most epic weapons... Smiths.
You know what? You like go see him and like spew out your like proficiencies and like whip out the letter of introduction and stuff.
Oh yeah.
And he actually asks you to teach him a few things.
Of course, that could be done for coin.
Yeah. He offers you, like, 3 gold per day.
What?
At first.
That's not bad.
That's not bad. I am a prodigy of the gods.
That's in your head, yes.
That sounds an awful lot like you're trying to get him to, or persuade him.
I will persuade him to four. And I shall teach him my basic skills that is probably so more awesome than his skills at best. I will teach him, like, the tier right above his. Like, if he's got the basics, I will show him the novice. I will, of course, not go for the Mastercrafted or Epic, but... Or the rare.
I mean, you're pretty sure you would be breaking, like, guild rules there.
Yes, yes.
Of course.
I would break the space-time continuum if I whipped out those skills. Mugshead has some mighty secrets in there.
Roll a persuasion check.
Of course, now he's gonna
Let's see how well you do. Ooh.
Guess
where
that.
Where do you put your price for teaching him a few tricks?
4.5 gold.
Per day.
Per day.
Yeah, you eventually come to an agreement at 5 gold per day.
That's what I thought we were gonna do.
So you, like, a slave at the smithy, teaching this old human dude a few tricks of smithing, like a dwarf?
Yes.
And
Lark's just going to be practicing with his new forced style of fighting.
Yeah.
Instead of just purchasing a new axe.
I basically just leveled up my strength.
No feet, huh?
Nah. Didn't really find one that I wanted. Plus, I have
Warcaster.
It's something.
Warcaster?
No.
I mean, it's kind of nice being able to have a shield in your hands, and a weapon, and cast spells. Or have you been cheating all along and not sheathing your weapon to cast spells and then not sheathing it, huh?
I've never really been using my weapon to cast spells.
Nah, you've actually been most diligent in background healing.
Yeah, I've been doing what a healer is supposed to be doing when...
that's not
very well, but anyways.
Yeah. Well, let's not forget about that hand crossbow.
Yeah, well, that thing goes down every time I
pass. So basically, all of you are working in one way or another throughout like a week and a half or so.
Yeah, I'm talking probably show the local town guards a trick or two to earn his keep.
Yeah, sure. Let's see. Living expenses. There's a whole section for this.
For those sleeping in the barn?
I mean, you're gonna be... yeah,
lifestyle expenses is... One silver is squalid. 1 silver a day. Yeah.
That's probably...
Or is 2 silver. Modest is 1 gold.
I'm not sure if that qualifies as squalid or wretched. But first... Seth, roll.
Oh my
let's
God.
See. That's 11 constitution saving throws.
What are you trying to do? 11 just the fucking statistics of this motherfucker. It's, oh,
probably God. Easiest to just roll a 11d. Oh. What
one.
Is that?
Yeah, okay. It's gonna be 10 then. 10d. 10d.
11d20 time plus whatever your con mod is.
4. Okay, so then it's 10d20.
Wasn't 11, he said.
Yeah, but I already
so
run.
Roll
10d20.
10d20 plus.
No, that 4? Doesn't work because the constitution modifier goes on each of them.
Ah, of course.
Okay, I'm just gonna roll for this
Yeah, just roll the dice. We'll add modifiers after.
May the gods be with us.
To mouse over it and see the different ones.
It's going down, okay? We have gone from 24, 18, 16. Do you see the fucking... Okay, 3, 4, fuck. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. God damn it. Okay, that was actually better than I thought at first, but... What was the DC on that one? Don't smile like that.
Considering 8 is the lowest you can ever get, you're pretty hardy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're very hardy. what's your constitution score?
19.
Okay. Let's see.
Mug rolled awesomely the first time.
Proficient with con saving throws, though, so.
Yes.
Proficient bonus as well. It's 3.
Reduce your constitution score by 6.
What? Why? Reduce it by 6? What?
Yes. Mark down what it is right now and reduce it by 6.
Oh my god. Okay. Yeah. So 13 now then. What happened? And how long am I gonna go around like a wimp?
I don't know.
He doesn't know. He says he doesn't know.
He knows. He just doesn't tell you.
You spend a week and a half in fairly poor conditions, infected from a rotten dragon dick.
Fucker.
Some mornings are better than others. You had like at least 3 days there where you were like super shitty, and like after the week and a half, as you like get together again, you like slimmed down considerably, like muscle mass is gone, you're like looking a little pale, some of your hair is falling out.
I don't have it in my beard.
Yeah, and other places.
Oh god.
You don't look so good there, Mark.
Thok, I think I need a doctor. A magical doctor.
I wonder, have you washed yet?
No, of course not. What? Why are you asking such stupid questions?
You should probably consider that first.
What?
And then a doctor.
The hell is that supposed to do about my feelings right now? What will washing up do? The sweat I have been making the last few days while working down at the smithy would be plenty of liquid on my body.
Yes. And any other remnants of the thing that shall not be mentioned?
Well, I have been soaking in it for quite some time. I cannot smell it anymore, can you?
Yes.
It's there still?
Oh, yes.
Oh, dear lord.
If I were you, I would probably just toss everything and scrub that armor. I would probably scrub that skull quite a lot.
Is there, like, a horse washer in town? I feel like I need something hard.
I'm pretty sure there's a waterfall nearby.
That could do it. Could you help me, Thok? Can you wash my balls for me?
Didn't you discard those in a dungeon?
Yes, you have a point. I don't have any balls to mention. I shall be on my way then and try to wash myself in the loch. I mean in the waterfall. I shall be on my way now. And I kind of slink away, wagging. Just...
And thus a plague spreads from High Barrow to Baron to Karen. Following the water stream.
This is so much worse than Dubik's Pass. Rock slides were heard.
So, Mug has a wash. That's
yeah.
Cause for celebration.
Well, that it would had to... the incentive was incentivizing.
And then what, I wonder?
You definitely feel a lot cleaner getting all that gunk off of you. I mean, it'll take time to see any considerable difference, but you will find out within a few days at least if you still need to see a doctor or not.
I guess I would need to find something more than a doctor.
Maybe. So
someone with ties to the netherworld or something that could kind of take my soul from the devil himself.
Perhaps. Or just like a party healer with high enough spells.
Well, that works too, I guess. If we want to be so little dramatic.
How's the budget looking after a week then? Should I remove anything or?
I think you've made your own.
How much gold did I make though?
Since you were living in super shitty conditions,
yeah.
You ended up making yeah, you had your jugs, so you probably didn't use much on ale either.
No.
So, it's been rationing.
So you made 48 gold.
48 gold?
Yes.
For all those constitution saves.
You had a couple of sick days in there where you couldn't teach. You just vomiting over a cow.
That's nice.
The passed out one.
Yeah. So after like a week and a half, you meet up with the old man in the inn. He like arrives in town, and one of you notices him first and then alerts the others. So you congregate in the inn. Mug is like left outside, like peeking through a window.
Now that's the sound that it makes anyway.
And the old man like looks fairly fairly well off for considering how long of a journey he underwent all alone through the mountains. Yeah, he looks like very like hungry and a little pale and shivers a little bit, but nothing more serious than that. And sit down at his table in the inn as he's like getting something hot in him. He looks up at you and says, oh, hello. I finally made it. Have the others arrived?
What? Yeah. We've kind of been here a while. We got the sword, though.
A while, but I walked here as fast as I could.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Oh, yes, the sword. Sword, of course. Ooh. Oh, yes, the sword. Did you find the sword? Yes, yes. Oh.
Fuck is pointing to the Aurora.
Yeah, I have it on my
hip. Oh, excellent. Yeah, that cannot go in. And that cannot go and fall into the wrong hands. It'll release something horrible. Horrible.
Yeah, well, it's too late. They already got what was inside it.
Oh. We're doomed! Oof. Yeah, the old man like looks at Leorora and then Thok, and then the sword, Leorora, Thok, the sword, and says, if they have recovered what I think they have, then Things are fairly bad then.
You should probably contact a big army then.
Yes, of course, a big army. I will leave at once and gather an army. Of course, yes. And he like gets up very slowly from the table, like starts walking towards the door. 15 minutes later, he opens the door and walks out, and you hear like clack, 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 as he starts walking down the street again.
Doc's just going to look at Leroy and just...
Should we ride ahead and do it for him?
Yeah, that's just...
The world can probably do with those few extra weeks.
Yeah.
But then, the biggest question. Yes. Boat or foot?
I didn't mind the boat.
Not the boat!
I kind of liked the boat, too. And,
it was a nice, peaceful way of traveling.
I kind of heard some Fuckers. Good words about Karen anyway, so I really want to see that coastal city.
Sure.
Dragon vaginas. Oh, by the way, I figured that it's not the Quinshu I'm practicing, it's throat singing.
Of course.
That fits Mug much more.
Mug, you're outside the inn, and yes. You see the old man like turn a corner and start heading north.
Is this, where did I last see this man? Was it at the Dancing Cockatrice?
Yes, I believe so.
I run towards man, or now I don't. Now I run, right? I don't waddle.
I mean, if you're, yeah, you can run.
Cool.
Yeah, he probably had an epiphany in his fever dreams. That's how he gained the mastery to or proficiency.
And
for
he probably off. Hasn't taken it off at all during the last week.
Well, I was just standing He's under the waterfall. Used to it. I didn't get undressed. I just stood under the waterfall. So I run up to him and...
clank, clank.
Yes, you can hear it. Clank, 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 clank. Stop! Can you smell something on me?
Yes.
No, I'm asking the old man.
The old man looks down at you and, like, moves his walking stick forwards, like, shuffles forwards very slowly. There's... Ooh! Young man, oh, you smell like, have you been smoking weed?
Probably, so I smell kind of pleasant then?
I suppose so, why?
I then just run back, like,
hey, good thing this. Priest of Pelor probably doesn't have anything to heal you with. He continues shuffling towards the north.
Shit! No!
Oh, you God. Forgot he was a priest too?
Yes.
Well, he's so fucking slow, you could just walk over to him again.
Yeah, but would Mug realize that?
Mug wouldn't realize that at all. Shit!
Mug, like... Giddily runs around the town and like keeps bumping into the dude like repeatedly.
Oh, I hope I find someone to heal me.
Yeah.
It's after I bumped into him, like there's got to be someone somewhere.
Yeah.
Probably an Alagan.
Yeah. Yes, that's if way you're not we're dead back in Alagan. Has he considered asking around town, at least?
I should probably start asking around town for someone to heal me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We can see probably someone in Karen much better. It's a big city. And, you know, we need a few days to see if the wash helped.
Dude, a few days would probably kill me. Have you seen what happened to me? I'm falling apart at the limbs. God damn it. And probably people in Highbarrow would... definitely know me by now. by the awesome throat singing I've been performing.
Yeah, and the sickness that seems to, like, some people are starting to get the...
I look like a ghoul.
Like the scratches themselves as well. So.
I run around and my jaw is kind of just flapping.
I mean, yeah. I mean, Mug, you haven't heard about it, but I think Thok and Leorora, you've definitely heard that people are coming down. It's something they've started calling dwarf rash.
Too bad I don't have good enough healing spells to fix it. Depends. How much would it take to fix them?
I don't know. What kind of spells do you have? You have a cure disease, for example?
Fucking don't have that yet. I actually have to see what...
I'm going to start putting up posters. Do you know anyone that could help this dwarf?
Actually, cure disease isn't such a thing. Cure wounds is the only thing with Q.
There's a...
Some disease,
diseases.
Restoration, however.
Yeah, there's restoration.
And I have to check if I have that.
Yeah, I think restoration is like combining everything that used to be cure disease and stuff like that. Mm. So, you've met the old man. Yes.
Several
rushed
times.
Off to the north.
I could have used detect disease or poison on him to find out. I have lesser restoration.
That do it, I wonder?
Lesser restoration. You touch a creature and can end any one disease or one condition afflicting it.
So, one disease. Among the many he has.
Yeah.
I'm guessing Melissa Restoration will just help against his fireballs.
I mean, if you don't want to heal him, you can just outright say so.
You have to come to me first and actually ask me to do it.
Excellent. So,
well, maybe Leora probably would react to everyone else being sick about it, or getting sick from it, though, so she would probably help the people, at least.
And if she saw, if she knew that I was the direct link to that...
I would have let him die.
Then you're here in the night... I'm going to kill this town, you know, Leora, and it's on you. I'm going to just keep on hanging up posters.
I mean, it seems to be a running theme.
Where are we now? Are we in that city?
High Barrow.
We're still in High Barrow.
Mog!
Yes, Leora, I'm dying.
Can you please go take a bath?
I tried that only 2 days ago.
2 days? Roll two.
I tried that just a few hours ago.
I walk over to him.
Bastard.
Place my hand on the shoulder.
She actually touches him.
My arm kind of twitches because I felt like something just... A nerve kind of just... I'm starting to fall.
And then
apart.
I whisper something in Elven.
Do I speak Elven?
No, you
don't. An ancient curse.
No, I don't speak Elven. Shit. You touch a creature that end. And can end either one disease or another. DM.
Is it good enough?
What happens?
Or is it just the fireballs?
Mug, you feel this strange warmth envelop you. As
I feel this strange warmth envelop me.
And... and I mean, you'll discover in a couple of days if the disease is completely gone or not, but you definitely feel much better than you did before Leorora touched you.
If I could touch you, Leorora, I would.
Yeah, I'm gonna go wash my hands now, and I think you should actually go take a bath before you actually get sick again, if that didn't help. So, Leora just goes and finds a bar of soap and scrubs her hands almost raw.
I'm gonna find a maid and bribe her to scrub me.
Great. Great. So the fireballs are spreading as well.
Yes. The fireballs is not that bad.
Great. So I think we can call the session here.
Yeah.
Next session. And the question is, do you want to head down to Airedale between sessions, or?
Might as well.
Yeah, might as well. We don't have anything.
What do you want to do?
Send them via Karen so he could see about getting his armor fixed up with some dragon scales.
Okay.
Then I could probably do something about that eye because I'm awesome in smithing.
Yeah. I mean, Mug could help you probably in some fashion.
Yeah.
But also, he doesn't trust Mug. You can hear it.
I just leave it to professionals.
If you do, I'll count this as basically downtime so you can travel via Karen and get down to Airedale again.
Yep.
And we can, I can figure out some kind of a time scale for that. So we can start back in Airedale next session.
Yeah, and then that will resync nicely with the other group, won't it?
Yeah.
So the question then becomes of the armor.
I will have an answer for you next session.
Okay. Seeing a portable ram strapped to the back of the orc.
You need two?
What could be better? One portable ram, I wonder. Two!
Yes, that's what I thought. Hold on, there's something. This is really stuck on there, isn't it? Fuck. Okay, yes, I'm good. You want two? And I throw it. Just doop, over the floor. Hold on, I'm still not done shitting, by the way. Can I check the pouches? Yes, really quick.